And now to an I-team investigation. The death of former New Orleans police officer Tommy Felix has sparked criminal investigation into his death. Senior I-team investigative reporter Richard Angelico here now with who will be held accountable in this case. Richie, it's been a long time coming.
Yes, it has. The death of police officer Tommy Felix could result in charges of negligent homicide, not only involving the bridge operator, but others as well. We spoke to the man heading up the investigation, Captain Brian Weiss.
We're looking at all different charges right now.
The death of police officer Tommy Felix is now the subject of an ongoing and complex criminal investigation. Detectives are working with the district attorney's office. And while no decision has been made about a grand jury, detectives hope to determine who is responsible for the series of events and the neglect that led to officer Tommy Felix's death on the Judge Seeber Bridge.
The primary reason was the failure of the bridge operator to ensure that the gate was down. If the gate was down, none of these other parts were fatal.
The operator was immediately fired, but we soon learned more about those failed and fatal parts. Warning lights were not flashing, poorly maintained electrical systems failed to sense the cross arm was up, and the critical failsafe, the steel barrier, Felix's last line of defense against almost certain death, was hopelessly broken.
The barricade that's supposed to come down when the bridge is going up has been inoperative, and in this case, chained for over a decade to prevent it from coming down.
Whoever made that decision could very easily be subject to what they call wanton or gross negligence, and that would make them responsible for the death. That's negligent homicide. That's what it is. So that is something the grand jury can look into. And if you're going to stop this type of error that's systemic within the system, you really have to go to the source. Who's making these decisions? There's got to be a memo someplace that somebody wrote saying we need to fix this, and somebody said, no, we're not going to fix it. We'll just take our chances. It's only a question of time until somebody was going to be killed.
People were killed and seriously injured as a result of repeated failures to permanently repair or maintain the safety barrier. In 1989, three people died. 7 years before that, two more were seriously injured and miraculously survived. A grand jury could get the answers.
There's just been a history of failures and poor maintenance. Would your investigation look at that?
Like I said, we're going to look at any bit of evidence we can find, sir. We will look at from the past to the present to what has been repaired to dealing with the operator. As much evidence as we can gather, we're going to use.
They have no firm date for when the investigation will be completed, but it is likely to be wrapped up and turned over to the district attorney's office by mid to late August. And let's hope they get to the bottom of this and find out who is responsible for these horrific series of failures that have led to so many deaths.
Well, one thing, those investigators on the state level, at least they've always said that they're going to stay vigilant on trying to find out who's responsible.
Yes, they have.
All right. Keep us posted, Richie.
Will do.